And good evening, I'm Erin Burnett. Out front tonight, Trump and friends, together unleashing a coordinated assault on the Justice Department, pushing Trump's theory that the FBI planted spies in his campaign. Now, they've provided no evidence to support the claim, the president himself offering not one fact or piece of evidence to support his incendiary allegation.
All you have to do is look at the basics and you'll see. It looks like a very serious event, but we'll find out. When they look at the documents, I think people are going to see a lot of bad things happen. I hope it's not so, because if it is, there's never been anything like it in the history of our country. I hope it's not true, but it looks like it is.
Of course, it looks like it is. We'll see what the documents say. He's seen no documents, he's seen no evidence, but he has no problem throwing out there something so serious. Even his own lawyer, Rudy Giuliani, has admitted that President Trump doesn't know if there was a spy in his campaign. So let's start with the facts, because here are the facts as we know them this evening. The FBI used a confidential source to speak with members of Trump's team. CNN is reporting that person was not embedded in the campaign, as the president alleges. And the New York Times reports, and this is really important, so hear me out. They report the FBI only sent the confidential source to talk with Trump advisors, Carter Page and George Papadopoulos, after the FBI received information that made them suspicious about those two Trump advisors' ties to Russia. Okay, so let's play again part of what Trump said today about his claims of a grand conspiracy against him at the FBI.
I hope it's not true, but it looks like it is.
He hopes it's not true. Here's the thing, you know, putting it out there again and again with no facts to support it, he's certainly acting like someone who wants everyone to believe it's true. In fact, he's the one who put it out there, and he's tweeted about his conspiracy theory 9 times over the past 5 days. That's 9 times in 5 days. And being the marketing success that he is, President Trump is even branding his alleged scandal.
We now call it Spygate. You're calling it Spygate.
No, we aren't. But, Mr. President, really, no one except for you and your cronies are calling it Spygate, because, as I said, there's no evidence or facts to support it right now. Trump's allies are taking the story and running with it, from television to radio to the halls of Congress. Here is what Trump supporters are hearing hour after hour. Take Trump's friends at Fox News.
This is a deep state political hit job now spying on an opposition party campaign.
The greatest scandal in modern political history, the FBI spying on the 2016 Trump campaign.
I think it's really unwise to dismiss out of hand the notion that the FBI could have found it within itself to spy on the Trump campaign.
The FBI's job is not to spy on, you know, campaigns.
The president of the United States just tweeted this. Spygate could be one of the biggest political scandals in history. He's right.
Those are the Fox TV hosts. Here are the president's loyal pundit friends and loyalists.
I believe they committed crimes in doing so. Purposely sent people into the Trump campaign to plant false information.
If there was a spy placed on the Trump campaign, it is the most egregious, most disgusting thing that our country as a democracy has ever seen.
It's clear that they had eyes and ears all over the Trump campaign.
They're acknowledging they had a spy, but they're now saying, oh, it was to protect Trump. It was to help Trump. BS.
And then there are Trump's friends on Capitol Hill who are eager to join the chorus and pump the boss's unfounded claim.
If they did this, if there was a plant, if there was a spy, if there was an informant put in the other party's campaign during the election, that is as wrong as it gets.
If they ran a spy ring or an informant ring and they were paying people within the Trump campaign, if any of that is true, that is an absolute red line.
Again, unfortunately, right now, there is zero evidence. Conservative websites, though, are jumping on board, pushing the theory, which lacks evidence. And the president said that this person, you know, the one he calls a spy with reckless abandon, was only there, according to his tweet, to spy for political reasons and to help crooked Hillary win. That's what he said. So now he's got this whole thing, right? Person is there to spy for political reasons to help Hillary. That is a huge thing to claim. It does threaten American democracy. It is not something that anyone should throw out there. The president of the United States should not be saying any such thing unless he had absolute hard evidence that it was true. He doesn't. He's admitted it. His own attorney has admitted it. And as of right now, there is zero evidence that the FBI planted spies in Trump's campaign to help Clinton. The facts don't seem to matter, though, to this president. What matters is if it's working for him. And by that measure, he can see a measure of success. Americans' confidence in the Russia investigation is slipping. The number saying the Mueller probe should end is up 6 points in just 1 month.